How's it going, everybody? My name is AH Money, and today I brought along AH Baby Wade, and we're going to be playing some Black Ops 2 multi-team hardpoint on the map Hijacked. He's going to go 157-7, and his score streaks are going to be the Warthog, Dogs, and Swarm, and this is definitely by far one of my favorite gameplays, because on Black Ops 2, one of the main things I did love were score streaks, and Baby Wade knocked out a lot of 100 pluses, so definitely go check out his channel. His link will be in the description below, and you'll be able to see a whole bunch of other monster-ass gameplays, just 100 pluses all across the freaking board. Black Ops 2 is his game. Now, in terms of a commentary today, since our video isn't exactly super long, what I want to talk about is the gaming industry today, and what I mean is more or less, how do you guys feel in comparison from now all the way back to your childhood? Now, I'm a lot older than your average YouTube viewer. I am 30 years old, so my childhood was a lot different. I played Double Dragon, Contra, Super Mario, Duck Hunt, some of the older games that most of you have probably never seen, but maybe have heard of. And I assume most of the people that are growing up these days play like Pokemon, Yu-Gi-Oh, or whatever else. But it's more of a relevant Call of Duty, Battlefield, Pokemon kind of era. And even if you were to compare our childhoods from today and then way back in my day, I really feel that within the last year and a half, the gaming industry has really just gone downhill. For example, when I was a kid, we didn't have blockbusters per se. Every game that came out was pretty much fun. And to compare some of the older games to, say, some of the newer games, they'd be like Flappy Bird, something that is just extremely irritating, Angry Bird, something really, really simple that just keeps your mind focused on the game. And that is basically what the games did for me in my childhood. It didn't really matter what the game was, whether it was The Simpsons, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, freaking Shinobi, Kung Fu. It was very simple. You basically just run left to right, hop on some freaking enemies, you beat a boss, and you're on to the next level, and you kind of redo the same thing over and over again. But it was kind of the simplicity of the game that made it fun. And sometimes the games were frustrating, like where you're playing Super Mario and that jump that seems super impossible is going to take you 15 tries to do. When you finally accomplish that jump, it seems very satisfying. And for me, what is disappointing about the games today is that the technology has come so far since when I was a child, yet the game and the storyline, the creativity behind the games, it doesn't seem they're as in-depth as they were when I was a child. And that is really disappointing, because with everything they have to do with a game, it seems like they're going to the extreme versus just making a game that's somewhat simple, somewhat entertaining, and just has longevity. A lot of the games today, they don't have longevity. And I am a true gamer. I play other games other than Call of Duty, but it just seems that within the last year and a half, 2 years, 3 years, there really hasn't been any game that has really just caught my eye that I could play nonstop. The last game that I was extremely interested in was Kingdom Hearts, and Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2 were out on freaking PS2, so it's been that long since I've been into a game, say like a game from my childhood, where I would just play a game, get tired of that game, pop in another game, and still be interested in that game just as much as the first one, get tired of that, and pop in another one. I could play games for hours on end, whereas today, I play games for the social aspect of it. I play with my clan, I play with my friends, I meet new people. I love the freaking aspect of being in a lobby and just talking crap to people. I'm not necessarily into the game. What I'm into is more just having fun with my friends. Whereas when I was a child, you played games solo for the most part, unless you got permission to go outside and go to your friend, and it was two players. But most games that I had growing up, they were one player solo games, and they were still fun. Whereas they have split screen games today, but split screening on Call of Duty is fucking horrible. And then any other game where it is split screen where it's not Call of Duty, it's still irritating because of the way the game is set up and the way the visuals look. I really feel that even though we've come such a long way in the video game industry, graphics and technology and how much memory we can fit on a game, whereas I remember Final Fantasy on PS1 was on 4 discs, and we've been able to take all that and put it onto 1 disc. Yet in terms of the fun factor and being able to play games for hours on end, that is lacking. With all the video game software developers, we should have multiple blockbusters to choose from within any year. For example, we shouldn't have to wait all the way until November 5th just to play Call of Duty. Because throughout the year, there should be numerous games coming out, blockbuster games that just keep us entertained and keep us focused on playing video games. Whereas I might play video games for a while, but once all my friends get off, I'm gonna go watch Netflix. And back in the day, if my friends didn't want to play, that's fine. I've got, you know, shitloads of games that I'd want to play for hours on end that would keep me entertained. And I really feel that the new generation of gamer, you guys are really missing out. Because when I was a kid, there weren't blockbusters, like I said. There were just games. You'd go to Toys R Us with your parents and you'd buy a game and you never know if it was going to be good. You never knew what the game consisted of. You just knew that you got a game. And it was something new and something fun. Nowadays, you go to the place, you buy your games or you rent your games, and it can be a hit or miss. It was never a hit or miss when I was a kid. It was always a hit. It didn't matter what it was always a hit. For example, Zelda, I was never a big Zelda fan, but Zelda was so fun as a kid because, I don't know, it was just something simple. You rode through the levels, you progress. It was something satisfying to the game, and I think that's what the video game industry is missing today. So, of course, let me know what you guys think down in the comment section. What games do you guys grow up on? What generation gamer are you from? I was playing at my friends yesterday, and I mentioned Contra and Double Dragon, and they didn't know what the fuck I was talking about. So, it lets you know how old I am and how much the video game industry has changed. Definitely go check out Baby Wade. He's got a pretty awesome channel. He's a Black Ops 2 monster. Let him know that we sent you. Catch you guys next time. AH Money out.